Hello students, today we will discuss about deviation through a thin prism. Thin prism is one whose angle of prism is nearly 10 degree or less than 10 degree. So in between that, you can say 8 degree or so. So if we have a prism like this. This is the angle of prism. If the ray goes like that, this is also prism. The ray goes like that. This is also the angle. This is A. This is also A. A is the angle of the prism. Now, this you can see that in these two cases, this angle is smaller than this angle. So, this is A1, this is A2. So, you can write that A2 is less than A1. So, this is comparable to this prism. This is a thin prism. And this is a fat prism. So, what is the basic definition of a thin prism? This thin prism. If the angle of this prism, if is greater than 0 but less than 8 degree. Then it is called a thin prism. Then okay, this angle is called a thin prism. Now you can have a deviation through a thin prism. In that case, what will be the, if you apply prism formula to such type of prism, then just a little bit of modification in the formula of refractivity or refractive index. So, in case of a thin prism like this, this angle is less than 8 degree. In that case, the incident ray always this delta deviation is always minimum. For a thin prism, the angle of deviation is always minimum. Whatever angle of incidence you have, this angle or any other angle, this delta is almost the same. Because this is very thin. This angle is more than 8 degree. 8 degree. It's very thin. So it's very thin. Then always it has minimum deviation. So therefore, what we'll do? We know that if an angle is small, say very small, then sine theta is replaced by theta. So sine of this theta, the sine is dropped, only theta is retained. So for a normal prism, thick prism or fat prism, this mu is comes out to be sine of A plus delta m divided by 2 divided by sine of A by 2. You imagine that this is the angle which is theta. You imagine that this is the angle theta or beta. But this is a, if theta is small, that means A is small. For any thin prism, A is small, which is nearly 8 degree or 7 degree, 5 degree, 2 degree, A is small. If A is small, then delta is also very small. Then A plus delta M is also very small. Then in that case, sine A plus delta M by 2 is only A plus delta M by 2. You don't have to write sine because like this. You strike off sine here and write only theta. Similarly, strike of this only write this, strike of this only write this. So, for a thin prism, we have mu is A plus
delta m divided to a divided to this one. This two will also cancel out, and we are left with mu equals to a plus delta m divided by a, or mu a equals to a plus delta m, or delta m is mu a minus a, or delta m is a into mu minus 1. This is the expression we are going to use for a, this is valid for simplism. This relation holds only for thin prism because we have dropped the sign in numerator and denominator. Now, this quantity mu minus 1 is called refractivity of the material of prism. This is called refractivity. Of the material of the prism. It is dimensionless, no unit, no dimension. These are the points I am writing here, not in place, no dimension. So, no unit, no dimension. Delta refractivity of the material of the prism. This formula is very useful. Okay, so this is the deviation through a thin prism. Thank you.